Agent Rowe, what's that spark I see in your eye?
Fee, you're aware my team was having a hard time developing a practical scope of work for the South Street Bridge project. We know there's discontinuous fat clay layers that run through the west abutment area, and we have perched water on some of the site. We need to do more intensive investigations in those zones, but we just don't know where they are. Our original proposal included 114 borings.
That sounds expensive. Why don't you seem stressed?
I get a little juiced by a challenge, Fee. I had an idea that we'd conduct some different tests to help us refine our scope, but I was getting a little bit of resistance from the team initially.
I take it you somehow managed to generate some energy within the group and win them over.
I showed them how I used a little inductive reasoning to figure out a game plan to explore broad stratigraphy on the front end so we wouldn't need as many borings. It's a great little angle, Fee.
And what exactly is that angle, Ro?
Electrical resistivity, Fee. Electrical resistivity.
Electrical geophysical methods include several technologies that characterize electrical differences between soil types. The data collected can help to develop stratigraphic profiles over large areas, locate the water table, and identify features such as karst and seepage zones. Electrical geophysical methods use an electric current to gather data about the subsurface. In an electrical resistivity survey, a direct current travels between two electrodes implanted in the ground. The difference in potential is measured at two additional electrodes, which allows for calculation of resistivity in the soil. Wider electrode spacing allows for investigation of deeper soil layers. Processed data from a long array of electrodes can be used to develop a resistivity profile of the subsurface. Electrical resistivity techniques distinguish materials having dissimilar conductivity, making them useful in identifying clay, voids, and water-bearing layers within more granular soils or bedrock. Electrical resistivity is the most common electrical geophysical technique used in subsurface investigation projects, but there are others. Induced polarization is a technique in which the change in resistivity of the ground with frequency is measured. In self-potential, changes in electric potential are measured, which are a result of conditions such as fluid flow and mineralogy variations. These techniques are particularly useful in identifying variations due to mineralogy, groundwater conditions, and groundwater flow.
You have no idea what a difference this is going to make. This fat clay layer is a significant factor in our design considerations, but it's like playing hide and seek. The layer is discontinuous, and I couldn't afford to spend time and money to put borings on every square foot of the site, find it, and get the samples I need for lab testing.
We can definitely help with this. And not only can I show you where to drill to find your samples, but I can show you perched and trapped water, if it's present.
You've read my mind. Perched water is my next problem. We know there are some zones of trapped water sitting on top of the fat clay layers. I need to have an idea where they are to see if or how it'll affect construction operations.
Okay, discontinuity is our bread and butter. We'll have some preliminary information for you shortly.
By arranging the arrays in multiple configurations across the site, varying electrode spacing and alignment, the resistivity data can be integrated to create a model of the site that includes soil type boundaries, variations in moisture content, and open voids. Obstructions and other buried items can also be identified.
This readout shows the differences in resistivity in the subsurface. We can predict the properties of the materials based on the resistivity readings. You definitely have some significant pockets of groundwater, and I think I found your fat clay. Oh, and it looks like we have some sort of buried structure over here in the southeast part of the site. You'll want to investigate that further. Now you know where you need to drill to get really specific data. And I found an issue you didn't know you had. I probably just saved you 3 months of work and a change order in one afternoon without even disturbing the site.
I won't complain about that.
Now, let's review the benefits of electrical geophysical methods. Electrical geophysical methods use flow of electric current to gather data about the subsurface. The technique includes several technologies, including electrical resistivity, induced polarization, and self-potential. Electrical methods are fast. Electrode arrays can be used to develop multiple subsurface profiles in a matter of hours. Electrical methods are non-invasive and can gather subsurface data without the need for borings. Electrical methods allow development of detailed subsurface profiles and even three-dimensional models to identify water, critical features such as karst and voids, and contrasting materials. When electrical methods are used early in an exploration program, additional exploratory activities can be streamlined, saving money and better defining project risks.
Ro, I think your solution is brilliant. I'm sensing a little undercurrent of excitement from you about using a new technology.
Don't be so shocked, Fee. I'm an engineer. I get a charge out of figuring out a better way to do things.